of pitching. And we'll finish up with lessons from Tug McGraw on warming up and knowing the strike zone.
Boy, I sure wish we had a reliever like Dan Quisenberry. He's some kind of fireman.
He sure is, Sam. And the quiz helps the bunch put out a fire of our own. Let's take a look. Kool-Aid Man, fire it up.
Ball four, and that loads the bases for the Saguaro Sharks. And guess who's coming to the plate? None other than Saguaro's heftiest slugger, Mickey Klein. The incredible bulk with two down in the final inning and the bunch leading by two. Looks like they're going to go for some relief.
Tough luck, Chick. I'm bringing in Andy.
And now it's up to little Andy and his first appearance as a relief pitcher. What a time for a debut. The incredible bulk has just devoured bunch pitching all day. Andy could become a hero here, but it's going to be a tall order. Andy looks in for the sign from the stretch. He throws, swung on and hit a long way to deep left center. Zach is going back. It's gone. A home run for the incredible bulk. A three-run homer in the final inning off of Andy, and the bunch lose a heartbreaker.
Andy, wake up. What's the matter? Are you afraid to pitch to me? How are you ever going to face the incredible bulk if you can't pitch to me?
I'm not going to. I just faced him and he beat me. At least, I mean, I thought he did.
Thought he did what, Andy?
Forget it, Skip.
Hey, someone ought to tell this guy about having bad dreams before an upcoming game is pretty crazy.
What's this about a bad dream, Andy?
I don't know. I see myself pitching the big game and I see bad things happening.
Well, I'm no psychologist, but it sounds like an anxiety attack. And if anybody knows about dealing with anxiety, it's a relief pitcher. And our guest for today is the best reliever in the game. Bunch, meet Dan Quisenberry of the Kansas City Royals.
Hi, Bunch. How you doing? Good to be with you.
When Dan Quisenberry first joined the Kansas City Royals in 1979, not too many people took notice. But within a year, he not only became the ace of the Royal bullpen, but one of the very best relievers in either league. In fact, since 1980, no reliever has more saves than the Quiz. And in 1983, Quiz shattered the single season record by saving 45 games. One reason for his success is his great control. Dan averages less than one walk per 11 innings. Another factor is his amazing sinker that causes most batters to hit ground balls. But the most interesting reason for his success is his strange underhanded pitching motion he calls down under. Although quite serious when opposing American League hitters, Quiz has been known for his unusual antics in the bullpen and off the field. No one can deny, though, that either on the mound or just fooling around, they don't come cooler than Dan Quisenberry.
So, Bunch, the Quistessence of Cool.
No, not you, Chicken. Dan Quisenberry.
Quistessence, do you think the chicken actually understands that word?
No, but I'm sure he understands the meaning of cool.
Or thinks he does.
Are you cool enough, Mr. Chicken? Fruit, Mr. Chicken?
Chicken. Come on, chicken. Johnny's asking you a question.
Boy, life sure is a dream today, isn't it? Chicken, do you really understand what cool is? That's just what I figured. That's not what we're talking about here. The kind of cool we're talking about here is the kind of cool that Quiz shows when he comes into tense situations in a ball game.
Well, tell you the truth, Johnny, I'm not sure I'm all that cool.
Come on, I've seen you out there. I mean, calm, confident, and all business.
Well, maybe, but I get scared plenty of times. In fact, just like Andy here, I see bad things happening before I'm even out there pitching.
You do?
Sure, especially when I'm sitting out in the bullpen waiting for the call to come in a tight game. There I am, knowing we have a small lead, and I'll probably be called to save it. Nothing I can do but imagine the worst. I look at the other lineup, at a guy like Eddie Murray. I see myself having to face him, 2-1 in the ninth. The guy's so much stronger than me. I throw a pitch and bam, there it goes. Blown ball game, the Orioles win.
Hey, that sounds just like me in my dream of the incredible balk.
So what do you do?
Okay, so now I've seen the worst. I try to see it again more carefully and see what went wrong. I look hard in my mind. Visualization, that's what I call it. Where did I throw the pitch that I imagined him clobbering? Ah, yes, right down the middle and up a little, just where a slugger like him wants it. No wonder he beat me there. Now that I've seen what went wrong, I'm prepared to face the real encounter and visualize where I want to put the ball.
And the result, Royals win and another save for the Quiz, and that's the way it was.
Okay, Andy, now back to that bad dream of yours.
I don't know. I don't think I ever want to see that again.
Andy, you've got to overcome your fear because everybody makes mistakes under pressure.
Don't ask for help, you're all alone.
Pressure!
You'll have to answer to your own.
Pressure!
I'm sure you'll have some cosmic rationale. But here you are in the ninth, two men out and three men on. Nowhere to look but inside, where we all respond to pressure. Pressure. One, two, three, four, pressure.
Okay, we're not under any pressure now. So let's relax and talk about the hitter in your dream. Now, who was he?
The balk. He's the big bat of the team we play today, the Saguaro Sharks.
Okay, let's try to see him again. Think back, visualize. Okay, now look and see where you threw the pitch.
I threw it right down the middle. He stretched out his arms and... Huh. I don't want to see it.
Let's examine the pitch. It's out over the middle and up a little bit. He's a big guy, right? He likes to reach across a plate and hit the ball. He's too broad across the chest to do anything else.
So?
So when you really face him, and you will, you throw it somewhere else.
Where?
Well, Johnny, you're the power hitter.
Well, being broad across the chest, I don't like to be pitched in here. So, as a result, pitch him high and tight. Cannot extend his arm. He can't get a big part of the bat on the ball.
Oh, I see.
And now that you visualize where you want the ball to go, it'll make it much easier when you really have to face him.
What's that?
Wait a minute, we have pictures back here. Come on, let's go.
All right, action. All right, chicken.